Doctor, if you're treating whiplash injuries or hypermobility syndromes, then you're going to want to listen to this presentation. This is how you're going to quantify ligament laxity and hypermobility if your patient has suffered a whiplash or motor vehicle injury, or really any type of traumatic injury that would have affected the cervical spine or the lumbar spine. With this product, SpineTech PRO, you're able to take flexion and extension stress radiographs, or your lumbar extension flexion radiographs, or your cervical AP open mouth lateral flexion radiographs, and analyze them for ligament laxity. Now, ligament laxity is ICD-9-728.4, but will be M2420 when the ICD-10s take effect. So there's a couple reasons you're going to want to do this. The first is to determine medical or clinical approach to treatment. Four things can cause that ligament laxity: dislocation, fracture, arthritic or degenerative changes, or what we most commonly see in practice, ligament laxity secondary to trauma. There are some legal and impairment standings that are going to need to be addressed, and these are best addressed when you have objective evidence. It's going to show that the patient has suffered a permanent injury, if in fact they have. It will help determine the victim's compensation. And also, if the patient has suffered more than 3.5 millimeters of translation in the cervical spine, or more than 11 degrees of angular variation in the cervical spine, the AMA consensus opinion is that they have experienced or suffered a 25% whole body injury. Now, in these images, you'll see red, green, and blue lines. The red lines denote the location of posterior longitudinal ligament injury that have surpassed the normal acceptable segmental motion limit, and that indicates ligament laxity. A blue line denotes segmental motion that is clinically significant, and a green line is normal. If you'd like to try SpineTech PRO, there's a free 10-day trial. Just go to spinetechpro.com. What you're going to get with this analysis is flexion extension translational motion results showing the measurement of flexion, the measurement and extension, the total patient result, clinically significant range, rateable limits, and the patient's rating. You're also going to be able to check their angular motion in degrees. If the angular motion is normal, it appears as normal, in red if it's rateable, and in blue if it's clinically significant. The software also does Pennings analysis. You're going to get a Pennings analysis showing whether the joint is normal, hyper, or hypomobile. And here's the readings in the normal column and the ratings of this particular patient. You also get analysis notes of measuring translation and measuring angular motion. Your patient and their counsel has an understanding of what these analyses mean. This software gives you more than any other software on the market. You get posture analysis included. You also get cervical and lumbar range of motion, and you can do motion of any single joint or multiple joints. Mensuration analysis of the cervical and lumbar spine, which make excellent report of findings for the patient to take home. You get a chart that you can select the areas of subluxation or segmental dysfunction. You also are able to put in your own custom treatment options so that you can create a recommended action plan for the patient that can be generated very quickly, and you're able to generate a financial agreement for your patient so they know exactly what their care is going to cost them. Again, this is all available at spinetechpro.com for a free 10-day trial. Doctor, don't pay more than you have to. This software is an incredible price and it is an incredible value. Thank you for your time.